Hello Capricorns, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you for the coming half of July. And they are all general readings which may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be entirely your energies, they may be the energies of the person or the situation you are dealing with, or they may be the mix of both. So please swap the characters and the situation according to whatever is going on in your life. And if this reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign as well as the Venus sign. Okay, so Sagittarians, Capricorns, something is about to take off in your life right now. Something is ready, you are ready to move ahead with something, but whatsoever you are moving ahead into, your life is into a major change. And for some of you, it has, maybe the change has already begun, but you may be at different stages. But what you need to exercise right now is that you need to balance before you move into whatever chapter it is in your life, whatever the beginning is in your life. With that, you need to weigh the pros and cons and balance the situation very wisely. Weigh the pros and cons very wisely, understand the situation, and then move ahead. Because once you move ahead with the Chariot card, it is a fast movement, and you may not be able to revert the decisions which you have taken, or whatever plans you may have taken to move ahead. Okay, it is not that you cannot revert anything, but yes, it will be very difficult for you to revert, because it is a very fast moving energy, and whatever change is coming, it may be a rapid change. Okay, it can be a fast movement change. So just balance whatever it is, balance each and everything before you move ahead, because it is a very good chapter. Obviously, it's not a bad one, it is a good chapter, but you need to balance things when you move forward. Okay, you have the Magician card. It is obviously a time of a new beginning. Definitely something major is going to happen, and it is a very, very eventful and an important part of your life right now. You have to move in with a lot of strength and courage. You need a lot of compassion towards yourself and with the people around you. Or you need a lot of strength to move forward with a new beginning. But with the Four of Pentacles, there is something. You have attained something, obviously. Till now you have attained, but it is a sort of selfish kind of an energy. You are either, you are containing you are just keeping yourself very restrained and keeping everything to yourself. Either it is an information or something very vital or important for you, whatever it is, but you are holding on to yourself. You are either, you are being selfish with the information, with the possessions or the resources you have to move ahead, or you are, because it is not secretive. It is not secretive. It is just a dominating type of a thing, that you want everything under your own hold. You want everything in your possession. It is something like that. Okay. Whatever you have built, you want your command on each and everything. This is the caution. You don't have to be like this. Okay. You have to learn to give to others also. This is the caution. You don't have to be selfish if you want to move ahead, because see, the illuminated tarot deck comes out with this. This is the 10 of clubs, which is a responsibility of a burden. If you behave like this, then it will be that people will not be cooperating with you, because they really don't know anything, and you also are not ready to share any responsibility or anything with them. So nobody can really do anything about it. If you want to take entire credit to yourself, perhaps if you want to do everything all alone, so that you only are in the limelight, whatever the situation may be different for different people, or maybe you are guarded, whatever it is, but you are keeping things to yourself. And if you do like this, then this will be your fate. Okay, this will be your energy, this will be your fate. It is, you will be overworked with the pressure so much that you will not be able to bear it also. Okay, it will be such a tiring thing. So the Chariot or this, do not do this to this positive energy. That is what I am trying to tell you. It is a very positive energy. It is a very positive beginning in your life, which is a major chapter of your life. Maybe it is a fulfillment of your dreams. But if you behave in such a manner, you will convert it into, you convert yourself into this situation. Okay. So basically what I am trying to say is, unburden yourself, share your responsibilities with other people, share your feelings with other people. If it is about feelings, though the pentacles normally are about material possessions, maybe you are too authoritative and you want to be the whole and soul, and you want to keep everything under your command. That is what I am getting. If you do that, this will be your outcome. Okay, so beware of this, and it is better for you to work in a group, or share things with others, give others the their due credit, so that you have a positive outcome and you are really liked and adored by the company or the team or whosoever you are working with. Okay, so let me what the guardian angels have to say is a zero. Okay, just it is 101%. Just see, magician, a new beginning with the guy, with the guardian angels also, the magician also, and the chariot also. Okay, so there is a definitely change of your chapter of your life, a new beginning. You are at the beginning of a wonderful journey. There is no need to have any fear, as guardian angels walk beside you at every step of the way. You have unique gifts to offer that would, if you will free yourself from what holds you back. New opportunities will present themselves if you truly believe. So do not hold back. Do not hold back and free yourself from what holds you back. It is both ways. If something is holding you back, free yourself from it, and you also don't hold back to anything. It maybe you're not selfish, maybe that is your experience of life that you're behaving like this, but just let go of this energy and you have a very nice beginning, and the God is really helping you. It is number zero is all about fresh beginnings. Okay, it is definitely something good is coming your way, so keep it good. Do not turn it into a bad phase of your life, and don't because ultimately if you are overburdened, it will not be good for your health, physical as well as mental. Okay, so coming to the Whispers of Love oracle card, number 7 may be of some significance for you, and this card has been introduced, this deck, just to give you an insight into your personal life, not the professional one, because tarot cards may be sometimes giving you a more professional reading, and this may or may not link up with the profession, this the tarot reading I've done. This is just to give you the insight into how to improve your relations with people around you, how to improve the relationship with yourself, and to create a harmonious atmosphere around you and within yourself. Okay, so this is all about your personal energies. Maybe this is what you need to hear, so that you work upon your, do that inner work, and you are happy. Okay, and it can help you in improving your relations with your partner, with romantic, if you are single, with your parents, with your children, with your co-workers, whatsoever. Okay, so the only thing that is real is love. Shift your focus back to love. So the guidance here is, just see, this is a tree which is rooted obviously in the ground, and it is encompassing the entire world or the globe within itself. It is just a representative of the fact that we as humans, though we are over here and maybe at different levels and different energies, but God is holding our hand. Just see the beauty of the card. God is holding our hand, and we are divinely guided by all the powerful energies. Just see the galaxy over here, the birds over here, the beauty, and this is the divine guidance. Everything is divinely guided, and though we may feel alone sometimes in this life path over here, just see the beauty. These are all people. Just see the beauty of the card in the trunk of the tree. Okay, so though we may feel alone in life over here, but overall in the eyes of God, we all are one. In the heaven, we all are one. Okay, so love is ultimately which is binding all of us. That is the message. And if you have been, in due to your circumstances, you have been dwelling on the negativities. Okay, if you are dwelling on the negativities, and you have been sometimes life offers you some experiences that you become a negative thinker. Okay, so you should understand that ultimately, if you decide to choose love in the sense, be loving to yourself, be kind to yourself, and be loving and compassionate to other people, and as soon as some negative feelings or thoughts come to your mind, deliberately just delete them from your mind instantly, and just feed yourself with the positive thoughts. Talk to yourself positively and to people around you positively, so that you just radiate love from your speech, from your actions, because ultimately you can conquer everything if you are loving with people. Okay, if you, people will understand the way you talk, the way you behave, everything is very positive, people will obviously be attracted towards you. So maybe this is the negative thing which you are doing, that you are maybe becoming a negative person, or too cribby, or frustrated because of work pressure, or very emotional disturbances, or whatsoever may be. If you are, maybe this is the thing you need to correct within yourself. Shift yourself from a negative energy person to a positive energy person, and be talk to yourself positively, raise your self-esteem in a positive way so that you yourself are happy and people whom you talk to are also happy. Okay, so what I feel over here is that you need to understand that ultimately it is love which will help you to conquer all your problems in life. It will help you to conquer the it will give you the solutions to whatever problems you have in life ultimately. Okay, if you cut off from people, if you keep on behaving negatively all the time, then obviously people will cut off from you. You will find yourself alone. Okay, so I think that is the guidance for you, Capricorns. That's all I have for you. Please like and subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.